We are going to see about some of the neat question in respirations of plants. Before going to say this type of question, you should read about study about the keynotes of respirations, which is helps to answer the number of questions. Now the first question is, in which of the following process carbon dioxide is not released? They are asking, we know that the fermentation process and the carbon dioxide is not released, we are neglect the answer A and B. The first C option is alcoholic fermentation. So during the alcoholic fermentations, it was released in a carbon dioxide as well as in a water, but in lactate fermentations it was not released in a carbon dioxide because all the sugars, not only a lactose, glucose, fructose, sucrose, this type of the sugars will not release in a carbon dioxide during fermentations. It is in a key point. So on the basis of the key points, I answered, I tick the options D. And second question, they are giving in a bath way, and through this bath way they are asking arrows numbered 4, 8, 12 can be. That is, the 4, 8, 12 mentions what they are asking. We know that in each pathway, the system will release an energy in the form of ATP. So, in path A, 4 is nothing but ATP. In path B, 8 is nothing but ATP. In path C, 12 is nothing but ATP. In each process, the system will release an energy in the form of ATP. So answer is an B, ATP. Next question, which of the metabolite is common to respiration mediated breakdown of fats, carbohydrates and proteins? We know that in Krebs cycles, before the Krebs cycles, the fats and carbohydrates and proteins are breakdown by using an acetyl coenzyme A. So answer should be an acetyl coenzyme A. Fourth question, the energy released in metabolic process in which substrate is oxidized without an external electron acceptor is called. That is, among the following, this four process, one is oxidized without an getting an external electron. So we surely know that the answer for this question is fermentation. Fermentation process, it will not get an any electron from any other things. So another question, anaerobic respiratory pathway is termed as, anaerobic respiratory pathway is nothing but is in a Krebs cycle or citric cycles. So it's also termed as ampliobolic cycles. Next questions, the overall glycol is Krebs and electron transport systems. Explain the formation of and that is in glycolysis, Krebs cycles and electron support systems releasing a ATP. A is an answer. The next two questions, during which stage in the complete oxidations of glucose are the greatest number of ATP molecule formed? That is, which process the greatest number of ATP is formed, they are asking. So A is in a glycolysis. From glycolysis we can get an 8 ATP. Krebs cycle we can get an 24 ATP. In the conversion of pyruvic acid to acetyl coenzyme A, in this process we can get an 6 ATP. In electron transport chains we can get an 38 ATP for dissociated glucose. So they are asking a greatest number of ATP is formed which process. So answer is an D. Another question, 1 mole of glucose liberator 12 kilocalories of energy in the form of ATP. If 686 kilocalories of energy is released, how many moles of glucose is needed for this reaction? So we know that 1 glucose molecule liberates 12 kilocalories, but how much number of glucose molecule, how many number of glucose molecule liberate the energy? 686. Now this is divided into 12, we can get in a 57. So answer should be in a 57. We have to see the another question. Hemiasmatic theory of ATP synthesizing in the chloroplast and mitochondria is based on, that is, chloroplast and mitochondria has played major role for absorbing in a photon. So answer is in a photon gradient. Next, in glycolysis, during oxidations, electrons are removed by it. That is, during a glycolysis, ATP is synthesized, G3P is participated, and molecular action is also participated in photosynthesis reactions. Here, they are asking, during oxidations, electrons are removed by using a NAD+. In which of the following do the two names of refer to one and the same things? The two names refers to only one cycles. Answer should be in a C, that is, DCA is nothing but citric acid cycle. DCA means dicarboxylic acid. And another question, how many ATP produced by electron transport chain? How many ATP is produced by electron transport chains? We know the answer is in a 38. Then Krebs cycles occurs in mitochondria. Then respiration coefficient for fatty acid. Respiration coefficient for fatty acid is always less than 1. Then maximum amount of energy ATP is liberated on the oxidations of, that is, maximum amount of energy is liberated on the oxidations of fats. Life without AB, it's not a reduction reaction, so free from, it's not an oxidative damage reaction, it is impossible, it is an anaerobic reaction. So, that is fermentations. Another name of fermentation is nothing but anaerobic reactions. Okay, then end product of citric acid cycle is nothing but carbon dioxide and H2O. Here the glucose acetyl coenzyme A is converted into carbon dioxide and water. Then RQ is respiration coefficient, is nothing but the ratio between a carbon dioxide and oxygen. So answer should be in a C. Then EMP can produce a total number of, that is, EMP is nothing but it's in a glycolysis process. During the glycolysis process, it will liberate or release 8 ATP. Apparatus to measure the rate of respiration is, we know the answer, it's in a respirometer. From the respirometer, we can measure the respirations, amount of respirations. Another questions, the end product for glycolysis, in glycolysis, glucose is converted into pyruvic acid. So, end product should be in a pyruvic acid. Watch the channel daily. You can get a more and more neat question from us and discuss with us. Thank you.